So guys, we're going to be telling you about external storage devices, and how to actually choose one for yourself, right? So let's just talk about, we're not talking about the flash drives, we aren't talking about pen drives, flash drives, any flash storage. We're talking about portable hard drives. These kind, and let's talk about these first. These are actually known as portable hard drives, whereas these big ones over here are known more like desktop hard drives. They're called desktop hard drives. Simple reason is these are based on 2.5 inch. They have 2.5 inch drives, and they can be connected directly via USB, and they do not require a power supply, unlike these that do require a power supply. And these have 3.5 inch hard drives in them, right? So these drives come in different shapes, though they all have 2.5 inch drives. And there's another way of having external storage, is by actually buying a 3.5 inch drive and buying external casing. This actually is external casing, and you can put 3.5 inch drive but inside, but they aren't really safe. If you're going to travel a lot with these, you have to remember to be really safe with them, because they have a chance of breaking. Here's an example of that. The drive inside doesn't really work anymore. So try, if you are going to buy it, it actually doesn't make that much of a sense right now, because maybe there's not much, maybe like 500 rupee or a little more difference in price between buying a normal desktop hard drive and actually buying an internal drive and buying a casing separately. Portable hard drives are more expensive than desktop hard drives because of the size, portability. Right, so in the market currently, you get the portable external hard drives, minimum of 160 GB. And it goes up to 500 GB, whereas external drives go up to 1 TB if it's standard like this. Plus you have other types of storage drives that actually can hold more than one hard drive in them. So that means you can also go up to 4 TB in an external drive, which will have two 2 TB drives in them. Okay. Those solutions are more used as backup solutions and can be arranged in RAID mirroring. And also, those solutions have the additional option of NAS, which is network access storage, so that you can transfer data directly over a network or use the network to store data, which most of these common desktop hard drives don't have. Okay, when it comes to storage, okay, I'm just going to give you a rough explanation of the price point. Like, say this hard drive is 320 GB, which will cost you around 4000 rupees, whereas a 500 GB hard drive is going to cost you around 5500 rupees. Okay, so basically you're going to get 180 GB more storage by paying 1500 rupees more. So if you do have a lot of data and you are quite mobile, you have to run around with work, and even if you carry a laptop and your laptop hard drive gets full, then we would recommend you get a portable storage device rather than a desktop storage device. See, a desktop storage device, a desktop hard drive, external hard drive, is more as a backup device and something that remains in one place. So if you're at home or something, you can just leave it over there. You can send all your downloads directly to that. It just acts like an internal drive, only it's external. Okay, so in terms of a desktop external drive, you're gonna get 500 GB for rupees 3700, whereas you can get a 750 GB for around 4500. So again, you see the jump over there, just with a little bit more money. So it makes sense, again, it makes sense to buy just the more. I mean, the more you buy, the more storage you have is always better, because you will run out of storage eventually. With the amount of content that's available on the internet and downloadable, we recommend you go for the higher storage capacity.